In April 1979, at the General Dynamics docks in Groton, Connecticut, in presence of government officials, was launched a submarine that became a milestone in the Navy history. The largest submarine built in America, this 170-meter nuclear steel monster with a displacement of 18,000 tons, is equipped with an arsenal capable of destroying an entire country. USS Ohio is the first of 18 flagships that became the basis of the US nuclear triad, ships whose performance is considered outstanding even now, 40 years after their appearance. The mid-1960s became the era when the space race between the USSR and the United States was at its peak. We all know about the mighty rockets of that time and the pioneers they carried to the stars. However, this race was happening not only in the peaceful venue, but also in the military one. The emergence of intercontinental ballistic missiles shifted the balance of power, and the US superiority was no longer undeniable. The Soviet missiles could hit US forces before they would be able to react. In search of a solution to this problem, the Pentagon initiated extensive research work. The program, named StratX, was supposed to be the beginning of modernization of the entire US nuclear triad, forces operating on land, at sea, and in the air. The result of this study was 9 promising key concepts, 5 of which related to the land-based military systems, 1 was aviation, and 4 were naval. One of the naval concepts assumed the creation of a group of large nuclear submarines, which would be on long-term duty at sea and carry missiles, the range of which would allow their use from practically anywhere in the world. The implementation of this concept consisted of 2 parts, a ballistic missile and a submarine. Work on the first part was launched in the early 1970s. The new missile was supposed to have a combat load and range greater than what the United States had at that time. And that's what happened. The Trident was born, which fully satisfied the requirements of the military. Parallel work was carried out on the submarine. Military and engineering calculations showed that the optimal carrier should have about 20 missiles on board. And taking this indicator into account, it turned out that a boat with a displacement of about 14,000 tons was needed. The work on the direct development began, and in the process, the boats became heavier and their arsenal grew. The main executor, General Dynamics, has seriously modified its electric boat shipyard, especially for this task. The lead boat was laid down in 1976 and named after the state of Ohio. The same name was eventually given to the whole new class. Initially, it was planned that the Navy would receive 10 submarines of this class, but in the process of building the first of them, ambitions grew. By 1981, when USS Ohio entered service, the Navy expanded the order to 15 units, with plans to expand it even further several years later. In total, between 1981 and 1997, General Dynamics transferred to the fleet 18 Ohio-class submarines. When creating the boat, the engineers were facing a lot of difficult tasks, among which was the combination of large sizes, power, low noise, durability, and equipment. And this is also taken into account the acceptable operating economy. The budgets are not endless, even at the Pentagon. Ohio is a third-generation boat. In terms of dimensions, it is a record for the US Navy. 170-meter ship with a displacement of about 18,750 tons. However, this is a record only for America. The Soviet Typhoon submarines, which appeared a little later, were monsters with a displacement of 48,000 tons. However, despite the non-record size, Ohio definitely has a record arsenal. Each boat is equipped with 24 ballistic missile silos. Even the giant Typhoon only has 20. Of course, this is first of all the merit of the missiles themselves, much lighter and more compact in comparison with their Soviet counterparts. The first group of 8 boats, put into service before 1986, was equipped with the basic Trident I C-4 missiles. With a launch weight of 33 tons, they had a range of 7,400 kilometers or 4,600 miles and could be equipped with 8 100 kiloton W-76 nuclear warheads. Starting with the 9th boat, USS Tennessee, the silos began to be equipped with the more advanced Trident II D-5 missiles, the range of which increased to 12,000 kilometers, 7,500 miles, and the combat load could already include up to 8 475 kiloton W-88 warheads, or up to 14 100 kiloton W-76 warheads. The missiles can be launched at 20-second intervals from a 30 meters depth at low speed and in waves of up to 6 points. In theory, all 24 missiles can be launched in a minimum time, with one salvo. Although in practice, such operations have never been performed. It is not so easy technically. Besides, firing 24 Tridents at once is way too expensive. Of course, a submarine is a submarine, and it was impossible to do without torpedo armament. The classic weapons here are four tubes loaded with Mach 48 torpedoes. The boat has a hybrid hull. The main pressure hull, inside which the crew and almost all systems are located, is made of high-strength steel and reinforced with ring frames along the entire length of the ship. On the top of the pressure hull sits a permeable light hull, which, like a roof, covers the missile silos. Due to the fact that the second light hull covers only the upper part, the boat is considered a single hull or hybrid. This design makes it possible to reduce the emerging hydrodynamic noise. A high and narrow bridge with horizontal rudders is located closer to the bow, in front of the compartment with missile silos. The main hydrodynamic rudders are four fins and a cross in the stern. The horizontal ones are equipped with large vertical modules. The maximum diving depth of the boat reaches 240 meters, or 800 feet. The submarine is nuclear. The power plant is based on one 240 megawatt General Electric SHG reactor. It provides energy to two 35,000 horsepower turbines, which are in turn connected to a propeller. The boat has one propeller, 8 meters in diameter with saber blades. The design and features of the propeller are still considered classified information in the United States. Plus, there are several additional power units and generators on board to back up and maintain the systems. This gives the boat a cruising speed of up to 25 knots. A special innovation of the new generation is the low noise level. A seriously redesigned propulsion system and the introduction of several operating modes made the boat incredibly quiet. Moreover, this parameter is considered outstanding even now, and at the time of the start of operation it was completely incredible, up to the point that during the exercises in the early 1980s, the equipment available back then often simply could not detect the boat. The boat itself is equipped with a very serious set of radioelectronic and hydroacoustic equipment. The basis of the AN-BQQ6 acoustic system is a 4.6 meter spherical antenna with almost 1,000 hydrophones. In addition to it, there's a huge number of passive and active elements on board, plus information processing automatic systems. Later, as part of the modernization, the AN-BQQ6 was replaced by the newest AN-BQQ10, with a common station and an open architecture, which simplified further upgrades. The boats can create hydrographic maps and exchange data with other ships in the fleet. The main patrol regions are the Pacific and Atlantic Oceans. To support 18 submarines, two naval bases were specially adapted. On the Pacific coast, not far from Seattle, the naval base Kipsat is located. Boats that are based there begin and end patrols there, although sometimes they can make intermediate stops at the Pearl Harbor base on the Hawaii Islands. On the coast of the Atlantic, in the southeast of Georgia, there is the naval submarine base Kings Bay. Each base has all the equipment for servicing boats at all stages, as well as infrastructure for training and serving the crews and personnel. The boat has a crew of 150 people. Moreover, two crews are assigned to the boat at once, called the Blue Crew and the Gold Crew. According to various estimates, Ohio usually patrols a sea region 200 by 200 nautical miles, forming maps and observing the situation in the controlled area. The service can be called quite calm. Such ships do not try to get involved in a fight, but sometimes there are funny moments. One such thing happened in 2009, when a small fishing boat was wrecked in the Caribbean. A lifeboat with 5 people ended up far from all routes, and after 4 days of drifting in the high seas, when hope was already lost, it was noticed by the crew of the USS Rhode Island submarine. just like that on a lifeboat, accidentally running into a nuclear missile carrier in the middle of the ocean. Pretty lucky. Ironically, the collapse of the USSR became a problem for the US nuclear submarine fleet. These ships no longer had anyone to fight. The ideas of the late 1980s to build 24 boats were discarded. Plus, new arrangements on the reduction of strategic offensive weaponry were supposed to limit the group of ballistic missile carriers to 14. At the same time, the Navy's own analysis of the potential showed that for nuclear deterrence, they really only needed 4. And this is taking into account the fact that the first 8 boats were equipped with the already outdated Trident I missiles. Under the threat of disposal, it was decided to do serious work on them. 4 boats out of 8 have been upgraded and received the current Trident II missiles. The other 4 boats awaited more large-scale work. They have been converted into cruise missile carriers for operations that do not involve nuclear apocalypse. Out of 24 silos, 22 were equipped with 7 launchers each. As a result, the ship received 154 Tomahawk missiles or similar devices. Another 2 silos were adapted for equipment and means of carrying out special operations. Considering that they didn't count as ballistic missile carriers anymore, the limitation of 14 units was not violated. At the same time, efficiency and relatively low operating costs made Ohio the main element of the US nuclear triad. At the moment, these 14 boats account for about 2,100 warheads, or roughly 60% of the total deployed US nuclear arsenal. For 2021, the entire group of 18 submarines is still in service, even though the first of them is more than 40 years old. And all of them are quite active, being deployed on patrols lasting up to 6 months. It is assumed that Ohio-class boats will begin to be decommissioned in 2029, and a replacement is already being prepared. By the time Ohio retires, it will be replaced by new strategic ballistic missile submarines and the start of the next class, the Columbia. The history of American flagships continues, but this video has come to an end. Comment below what you think of these nuclear giants, and of course, subscribe to the channel as to not to miss new videos. There's still a lot of interesting things on the horizon.